Everything in my life has been by luck rather than by chance. I had no major in college, no real technology classes, no business classes, and my business career, the most important part of it was helping to start 6 companies. When I graduated from Columbia, I was commissioned a second lieutenant in the Marine Corps. Fortunately, it was in between wars. Korean War ended when I was an undergraduate, and Vietnam hadn't begun. And the Marine Corps sent me to Japan, and my orders read for me to go to the Federal Office Building in San Francisco for transportation. I spent 14 months in Japan, and in that month that I was waiting for transportation, I fell in love with San Francisco and decided that's where I wanted to live. When I came back from Japan, I was released from active duty. I had to go to Treasure Island every morning for physical and all the paperwork to be released, and every afternoon I looked for a job. The only job I could find was selling life insurance. And I started at the end of March, March 28th actually. On December 31st, I was 5th in production out of an office of 45 men, but I hated it. And while I was in Japan, I got a letter from a high school classmate who was bragging about his career as a stockbroker. Well, I knew nothing about stock, but I knew it had to be better than selling life insurance. So I tore the yellow pages out of the phone book, started at the top of the alphabet, and I got down to W before anybody gave me a job. And before you can be a stockbroker for the New York Stock Exchange, you have to go through 6 months of training. Well, that was the only training I ever had in business. And when I started production, I was fortunate to get a big account right away. He'd come into the office at the opening at 6:30 in the morning, and by 10 or 10:30, he'd given me enough orders. He would say, "That's enough for today, let's go fishing." And he had a yacht at the Marina Harbor in San Francisco, and would go out in the bay during the week for striped bass, and we always caught the limit. And then on the weekend, when it was salmon season, we'd go out for salmon. When he pulled out of the harbor to go for salmon early on the weekend, all the party boats were waiting for him. He knew the fish better than anybody. Never went fishing with him when I didn't get the limit. I joined the Marine Corps Reserve Unit at Treasure Island because I needed the $150 that they paid me for a weekend. And I had a sergeant there who worked for an investment banking firm called Blythe & Company, and he was a municipal bond trader. And he said, "Lieutenant, there's a great job at Blythe, you ought to apply for it." And he kept bugging me every day when I was a stockbroker to go look about this job. Finally, I said, "Gene, I'll go, but after I go once, don't ever bring it up again." And I went. And they offered me a job that was far more money than I was making and sounded very interesting, but they said you have to take a test. So I went up to another small office where a man by the name of Charlie Meek was sitting, and he hands me a test booklet. He said, "Read this front page carefully. The last sentence on the booklet was, 'Do not open this booklet until you're told to do so.'" He picked up the Wall Street Journal, put his back to me, and was reading the paper forever. And finally, I got tired of waiting, and I opened the book. He turned around and he said, "You're not supposed to open the book." I said, "Well, I'm not going to sit here all day while you're reading the paper." I found out that was the test. If I had not opened the booklet, I would not have gotten the job. I hung up the phone, and the receptionist walked in my office and said, "There's a Mr. Bob here to see you." And he said, "I'm right here." He followed the receptionist and stuck out his hand There's a couple of gold things in his hand. He said, I wanted to start a company to make these. Need $250,000. I didn't know what he was talking about. I kept asking all those stupid questions, and finally I realized, gee, this could be really important. And to make a long story shorter, he walked out of the office 2 months later with $1,250,000, and a company was called American Microsystems. It was 2 years before Intel. It was before anybody called the name Silicon Valley. Well, American Microsystems was the first company in the world to make what's called MOS chips in commercial quantity. MOS is what makes the microcomputer possible. And the stock went from $1 to 65 in 18 months. And the guy that started it bought a sailboat in Seattle, one in Newport Beach, one in Florida, and an airplane, and stopped running the business. We all did well with the company. I sold my stock at 42. But it could have been the Intel of the world if he didn't like sailboats and aviation. At some point, Columbia gave me an award, John Jay Award, and I had to give a little talk at the dinner that when they awarded that. And the only thing I could think to say about my education was it gave me a keen sense of ignorance. And that ignorance allowed me to ask all the stupid questions I had to ask until I understood something.